Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijer, a retired lecturer in Metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm revising my book, and this is chapter 10 on the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. And this is number 3 video. So further, Christ and not Saint Luke's. So no, people have used the word saint, you know. No, saints are to be used with caution, you know, because they have created this Gregory and this and that as saint. They were not saint, you know. The Christ are those people who preach gospel. Apostles, they are Christ. If you cannot preach gospel, it doesn't come from your heart. And you just read the book from here and there, then you vomit it out or explain, then you are not a Christ. You are just, they call you saint. So the real title of those apostles, it was Christ. Thomas went to India. He was not known, over there was known as Saint Thomas, but they called him Christ Thomas. And his laborers also were known as Christ. So Christ are people who drink the blood of Christ. They become like him. We preach gospel with authority as our anointed elder brother Christ, Jesus preached. So further, Christ and now Saint Luke has stressed the significance of the five in Luke 12 verse 52, far from henceforth, that is in this dark age of spirit and not of the works which were the past ages anymore. There shall be five in one house. One house is physical body divided. Three, now those three are of id, or ego, or home in Punjabi, which are lust for sex, kaam, anger, which we call krodh, and third one is haughtiness, which is hankar, of the letters of the books, as the university professors display. That means pride, you know, haughtiness. So against two are of mind, called man in Punjabi, nafs in Arabic, which are greed, which is lobe, and second one is worldly temptations, moh. So these two are of the mind, the other three are of the id. So when your id and mind is under control and under the control of the wisdom or Holy Ghost, then you have overpowered them, you know, those five. So then he said, and two clever psychic of evil spirit against three, simple helix of flesh, which we call stones. If you are hungry, turn stones into bread. So these are called the stones. Simple-minded people. Greedy people cheat the simpletons, and that creates among the poor a grudge or a friction against the rich. Holocaust and the Russian Revolution were the result of such struggles where the poor fought against the rich. Russians is a good example. Communists are the nearest to the God because they are neither rich nor poor. But now, you know, the disparity is coming up, and so the ugly head of the Satan is appearing among the Russians. And Luke 14, verse 18 to 20, and they all with one consent began to make excuses. This is the laborer invited, you know, to come to the feast. And how they made excuses? They are according to the helic, psychic and nomadic people. And they are opposite, you know, evil one. The first man of flesh, or helix, said unto him, I have bought a piece of ground, and I must needs go and see it. That means the helix or the firstborn, they are after occupying ground, you know, how many houses or how many field he owns, the amount of land he owns. And when you die, you need only 6 foot land. So this is the of helic, you know, to boost their ego. So the person, you remember the marriage of the son, when the person was sent, go call my people. So that is the excuse they were giving. So I pray thee, have me excused that I can't come for the work, for the marriage of the son. That means they are engaged in their secular duties. And another man of evil spirit or psychic said, I have bought 5 yokes of oxen. 5, again, you know, those 5 temptations. And I go to prove them, that I want to test them, you know, to take the advantage of those 5 evils. The psychics are always the victims of the 5 spiritual robbers, and they are too busy enjoying the evil fruits of evil spirit than to pay heed to the services of God. I pray thee, have me excused. Another wise nomadic person, too busy in his family love, that is more worldly temptation, you know, to serve God as a roving preacher, said, I have married a wife and therefore I cannot come. That means he is still in the family life. He cannot renounce his family. So I can't come to serve God. Finally, it is worth stating here that the 12 close circle laborers of Jesus that were his yeast signify that his ideal laborers would be perfect in the 7 moral rituals embodied in the 7-candled menorah in the name of John the Baptist. And they would also have their heart pure of the 5 spiritual temptations in the name of Christ Jesus. Christ is concerned with these 5 temptations of the heart. If you know the star of Bethlehem, it has 5 corners. So 5 corners represent these 5 temptations of the heart. That is, the true laborers of Jesus would have both body of sins and heart of blasphemy circumcised, purified, you know. Now let us interpret the relevant section of the parable, John 4. He told her, go, call your husband and come back. I have no husband, she replied. That is, go and bring your teacher. That's why Jesus said, you know, the one who taught you all these spiritual things, you know, Rabbi, go and bring him. Because she said, no, she is independent. She have learned it from the basic principle and she speaks with authority. That means she has no teacher. That is, go and bring your teacher who taught you this spiritual knowledge. But she was solitary, like the person of John 9, the born blind person whose eyes Christ Jesus opened with his spittle, with his mouth. Whosoever drinketh from the mouth of Jesus becomes like him. So this Samaritan woman was like the John 9, born blind person, outspoken, authoritarian. In fact, she has so well understood the spirituality of God from her rabbi that she was solitary virgin, leading a pious life as the Samaritans and Gentile did used to live. Now, when you have Christ in your heart, then you don't go by what this man say, what that man say, or what this book say, or that book say, but what your Christ has deducted or interpreted logically thinking, you go by that. Logical thinking or logical reasoning is called logos. Logo is his word. So your Christ in your heart is brewing the new wine inside your heart and keeping you virgin, that you are not dominated by anyone. So in Christ Jesus, we are solitary virgin. And when those apostles, laborers of Jesus, were married at Eucharist, Jesus washed their feet to entertain them into the house. And when they were married, they were still virgin after the marriage of the son with these 11 virgins. In the spiritual world, it is opposite what is in the physical secular world. In secular world, when a virgin marries a man, then she is no more virgin, but become Mrs. So-and-so. But in spiritual world, even after marriage, you are virgin. Because first, when you were a child, you were under the control of your parents. When you were under the control of your parents, you were not virgin. Because whatever parents told you, you did it. But when you know you grow up, become sensible, and then you can think of your own, and you have Christ in your heart, then you become virgin. And when you become virgins, then you marry the son and these who were the one who became by through meditation and other things one with God, then their God is their husband and they are virgin in God. We call them Suhagan. So in spiritual sense, after marriage, the person remains virgin, because when you are marrying, remember the parable of the when she married the seventh husband, there is neither giving nor taking. That means they are at parity, they are at par. So when we marry with our husband, Christ Jesus, in whose name we preach the gospel, then we are at par with Jesus, and we are still virgin. So this, I hope, will become clear what is best understood by discussion, face-to-face discussion. I can explain it better then. That she was solitary virgin, leading a pious life as the Samaritans and Gentiles did used to live. Or it was like a PhD. You know, when a student does a PhD, student who does research under his supervisor, rabbi, and on getting his PhD degree, he becomes solitary like his professor. So this is similarly, you know, in Jesus, when we get the training, we are laborers working in the vineyard of our Father, and when we are well trained, then Christ Jesus, at the Last Supper, he trained them so well, they all got PhD degrees, that if a stranger comes, He would not know which one is the real Christ, because they were all qualified like Christ Jesus. That is why they hired Judas Iscariot, the insider, to tell us which one is the real Christ, so that they can catch him. So that is the training Christ Jesus gave. He made them at par with him. He emptied himself and made them perfect to his best ability. This Christ, Philip has stressed, that a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. So such is the nature of those Gentiles, because their heart, their moral laws are written over their hearts. Hearts are living. So those moral laws are living laws of the living God. Whereas the Jewish laws, they were written in the dead letters, in the book, dead books. So that is why their laws are dead. And that's why Christ, Paul said, letter killeth, spirit giveth life. Thus she was so confident in her thoughts, her spiritual knowledge, that she did not need to consult a rabbi, that Samaritan woman, you know. She was as solitary as the laborers of Christ Jesus were. Jesus said to her, "You are right when you say you have no husband." In this statement, Jesus clearly confirms the answer given by the woman to the questions put forward by Christ Jesus, that she is really a solitary virgin, led by her own Christ in her heart, the bridal chamber. Remember when Jesus was eating at the Matthew's place, for some Pharisee Sadducee came, "Your laborers don't wash their hands, they don't pray like those of disciples of John the Baptist do, or Pharisee Sadducee do." Now this is important. That means Jesus had no disciples and they were not praying or fasting. So why do you pray in the churches now? Because Jesus did not pray, or his laborers did not pray. So this is all messianic corruptions. So that is what Jesus said. So far, their bridegroom, Christ Jesus, is in their bridal chambers, in their hearts. They do not need to pray or fast. But when, you know, your heart is dirty, hypocrite, Christ can't rest in your heart. Then you pray and fast, you know, to show to the others that you are a religious person, but you are a crook in heart. The answers came from her heart. Whatever she, like the born blind person, you know, the answer he was giving was from his heart, not from any book. He hasn't read any book. Same this Samaritan woman, all the answers she was giving were from her heart and not from any book, as the Pharisee and the Sadducee or the university professors would quote in their discussions. In fact, the woman was married with a family and she became Christ Fortina, and her whole family members became preachers in honor of Christ Jesus, to preach gospel without any fear of death. Emperor Nero killed them mercilessly, and you can find the story if you Google St.Photina, Russian, etc., or come to my website. I have put the article of this one. I came to know of her story through an article by Bishop Anthony of Russia. Anthony or Sorozov, I can't spell that. Russians even know that John the Baptist was an angel of Israel. Sikh holy books also proclaim the same truth with stress, that He is friend of those who are faithful to Abraham and killed those who are unfaithful to Abraham, are the sons of Satan, the tares. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. So all these holocausts were made by the unfaithful to Abraham people. If they were faithful to Abraham, they would not have suffered. They did not need to leave their promised land, because the promised land belonged to Abraham. It's only for the sons of Abraham, not to the unfaithful tares, sons of Satan. For you have had five husbands. So these were lust. That's what Christ Jesus said, you know. For you have had five husbands. These were lust for sex, which she had subdued through morality. Jews are immoral compared with Gentiles. Anger, which dominates the men of flesh, or the helix, she had overpowered it through Holy Spirit. And she was not a stone or fool, as you find people in churches who employ a hireling dog-collared priest full of the old wine of the letters, university degrees, desiring not the new wine. So when I go there to these churches and tell them things of the Spirit, and they say, your philosophy is different. We can't understand. So, but she was sensible enough to engage Jesus, a person of Holy Spirit with capital S, into a deep religious discussion that even surprised the laborers of Jesus, and they were spellbound not to interrupt their discussion. Greed, she overpowered by leading a simple, contented life. Samaritans were neither rich nor poor, as they would not cheat each other. Communists are nearest to this society of Gentiles. Worldly attachment, she overpowered by leading a life of contentment and mercy, as the Samaritan man displayed in picking up the wounded person and looking after him too. And finally, the fifth one, which was the last husband living with her, no more her husband, haughtiness of her religious knowledge was subdued by Holy Spirit, because she learned the subject by through Holy Spirit, not by the letters, through which she was understanding gospel and clarifying her doubts for a perfect peace of mind. So she was discussing with Jesus any doubts she had in her mind. So Jesus then clarified to her, gave her a perfect peace of mind. And the man, that is the pride or haughtiness of religious knowledge you are now living with, is not your husband, is not dominating you either. What you have just said is quite true. That is, she was a solitary virgin in the manner of the born blind person of John 9. Sir, the woman said, I can perceive, not see, you know, seeing is flesh, perceiving is of the Spirit. I can perceive, not see what is written in the Bible, that you are a prophet. That is, the woman was so spiritually advanced as to tell Jesus that he seems to be a perfect, he seems to be a prophet. Our fathers in flesh worshipped their tribal gods called Illah. Now the people of the Ishmael, they worshipped Adam and Illah. While these are Jewish people, Isaac, they did not. They were proud, you know, that they have spiritual knowledge, so they forgot about the Adam and the angels. So that's why the Jacob had struggled with the angels. That means unfaithful to the tribal father. That is a different discussion. I won't go deep into this one. On this mountain, by spirit, in India, the people in the Middle East, they will honor their tribal elders because that is the salt they carry, characteristics they carry. Remember that Abraham was a righteous person, good, honest person, not the like these the sons of Jacob became crook. They wanted to kill Joseph. All right? So they had no salt of Abraham in them. They were unfaithful to Abraham. And that is what the Jacob, struggling with the angel led to. So these people, Gentiles, they always honor their tribal elders. And that is why baby Jesus was sent among them. So they honored Jesus. They looked after Jesus well, like the sons of man. While the sons of Satan, the Jews, they wanted to kill him. On this mountain, by spirit in India, we call such a place, a mountain, or place as Jethere. When the person is get married, a boy get married with a girl, then the girl will come to the village, to the boy's village. And they will then take both boy and the girl to the place where their first elder came and settled. That place, they will go there and pay tribute to him. That is called Jethere. And that is what these were in the Middle East, they were doing, worshipping on a mountain. Their tribal illa. The tribal elders who founded the village. But you Jews of letters claim that the place where we must worship is in Jerusalem, where no tribal gods were worshipped. And the crook Jews fleeced them so much, so that James the Just had to beg them return their money to the Samaritans. Samaritans would be cheated. They go to St. James the Just and tell him the story. He will go to the rabbi and get the money back from him. They were not happy when they returned the money. This reference is to the worship of the statues of dead gods and goddesses, which were used by the moral teachers as the visual aids in teaching the moral laws to the youngsters. This type of worship served its purpose when the moral teachers were men of spirit and their praises were with God and not with men. So I think it's getting too long. I will do the rest in the next video. Our Father God bless.